In this video, we'll be installing SQL Server 2012 Express as part of our Pi Server installation. In the previous video, we planned out our installation by reviewing documentation, reviewing Pi system components, deciding on architecture as well as machine sizing, and lastly, we downloaded all the relevant information from tech support, including documentation as well as all the install kits. If you already have a SQL Server installed, or available to you on the network, you can continue with our next video where we'll install the Pi server itself. So the first step we'll want to take in installing our SQL server is to review the documentation. In our last video, we downloaded a white paper on installing SQL Server that we'll want to pull up now. With that up, I'll want to review what prerequisites I need before I can begin this installation. Looks like they're on page 5. And it looks like we have three prerequisites. Those prerequisites are Microsoft .NET Framework 3.5, .NET Framework 4, as well as PowerShell 2.0. In Windows Server 2012, .NET Framework 3.5 is no longer installed by default, so I know I'll have to add it manually. The other two components are already present. So, to install 3.5, I will need to open up my Server Manager. Once that's open, I need to go to Manage, and I'll want to add a feature, which is the Microsoft .NET Framework 3.5. From here, I'll follow the wizard's prompts. I know I want a feature installation, and I want to install it on my Pi SRV machine. Continue down to Features. We'll see here I can enable .NET Framework 3.5, and I'll go ahead and click Next. You'll notice here that there's a warning label at the top of our screen, and it looks like it's saying that we're missing some source files to install this feature. If we try to just click Next and install, the installation will fail unless we are connected to the internet. Thankfully, Microsoft has published a KB article on this topic. The KB number is 273-4782. And if we take a look at that, this gives us the information that these are error codes because the computer cannot connect to the internet and download 3.5. So they go through a few methods here of how to correct this problem. What we're going to be doing is using this method 4, where we can specify an alternate source path for these installation files. So let's go ahead and do that in Server Manager. So I can come down to the bottom here and specify an alternate source path. I've already downloaded these files onto my local machine, so I'll just need to point the installer to them. So I'll copy this path and then specify it here and say OK. With that specified, I should be able to click Install, and .NET Framework 3.5 should install. All right. So it looks like our .NET Framework 3.5 has finished installing. So I can go ahead and click Close. Also can close out all my other windows. So now that our prerequisites for SQL Server are done, we can move on to installing the SQL Server. It is important to note that we are installing SQL only 4AF and will be mainly keeping the defaults where possible. For more information on best practices with SQL, there are some more details in the white paper that we've brought up previously, as well as available from Microsoft. So now what I'll want to do is I can use my white paper and navigate down to the next step and see that it'll want me to run this setup file as an administrator. In order to do that, I must be part of the administrator group. I can check on that by coming to Computer Management and then checking my local users and groups. So if I look under groups, there's a group for administrators, and I can see my name right there as part of the administrators group. So I should be able to run it as an administrator. So what I'll do now is navigate to my install kit. I can right click and run it as an administrator. Okay. So it looks like our installation package is ready. So what we're going to do is select a new SQL Server. And through this process, I'm going to be following the steps outlined in that white paper. Okay, so our first step is to accept the license terms. And then SQL will check for any product updates that are available. And it looks like it's found one update for us, so I'll go ahead and install that. Okay, so now we can see we're ready to do some configuration. If we look over here on the right, we can see that our prerequisites are installed. Like I mentioned, we enabled 3.5 and then PowerShell and the .NET Framework 4.0 were already on the machine. And it looks like the install kit will take care of the 2010 shell. So we can leave all the defaults on this page, as that's all the AF server requires. So I'm going to go ahead and select Next. Now we have the option to name our instance. We can just leave this as the default and click Next. Okay, and now we have the option to configure service accounts. So it's best practice that the SQL Server run under a low privileged account, such as a network service, or a specific service account on the domain that's been given only the correct permissions. In our case, this NT service SQL Server account will work. And we also can configure the SQL Server browser. In this case, we're going to disable this, as we do not need remote connections to the SQL Server, and that's its only purpose, so we're going to disable it as a security check. We can also take a look at the next tab. However, we will just leave this as default and click Next. So next we need to specify our authentication mode as well as our SQL Server administrators. OSIsoft recommends you leave the Windows authentication mode checked. And we also recommend this for the SQL Server administrators, that instead of a single user, it's pointed to a group. So in this case, the install kit has accepted me as the only administrator because by default, it adds the person running the install kit to this list. We'll want to change that and add the local administrators group from this computer. So I'll go ahead and click Add Locations. I'll click Pi server, which is our local machine. And then the box here, I'll type in administrators. And then I can check names and click OK. So now you can see our administrators group for the local machine is added. And as we checked at the beginning of this video, I'm part of that group. So I will go ahead and remove my own name. This will make it a lot easier to manage permissions later. Next, we can check on the data directories tab. We're going to leave these as default. User instances, we're going to disable as it is not used by PyAF. And file stream, we're going to leave the default. We can then select Next. Error reporting is our final configuration option before the install proceeds. This is completely optional, but I'll go ahead and check the option to send these errors and click Next, which will begin our install. Okay, so it looks like our installation is completed. We can check to make sure all the steps succeeded. And if they did, we can go ahead and click Close. And now we are done with the install of SQL Server 2012 Express. Now we are ready to install the Pi server, starting with the Pi AF server. And we'll do that in our next video.